Hi students, good morning. Today let us learn about immunity. Every day we expose it to large number of microorganisms. But every microorganism will not cause disease to our body. This is due to the fact that our body has an ability to fight against the disease causing organisms or any foreign substances. So let us learn the definition of immunity. So immunity is the overall ability of the host to fight against the disease causing organism, which is confirmed by the immune system, is called immunity. So immunity is a overall ability of the host to fight the disease causing organism, and it is there in the immune system, is called immunity. So immunity is also called resistance to disease. Let's see the types. It is of two type, you can see. The first one is innate immunity and the second one is acquired immunity. So immunity is of two type, innate and acquired. So what is innate immunity? Innate immunity is the natural defense system of the body which is present at the time of birth. Andre hutbekadranne iruvanta immunity nenanta galithivi innate immunity. It is a natural defense system of the body, which are present at the time of birth. And they are non-specific because they give generalized effect against wide range of microorganism. They show generalized effect. The effect of innate immunity, which may vary from person to person. And ellarallu onde tarala innate immunity andre it may vary from person to person. So innate immunity is of four types of barrier, you can see. The four types of barriers are physical barrier, physiological barrier, cellular barrier, as well as cytokine barrier. So innate immunity has four barrier: physical barrier, physiological barrier, cellular barrier, as well as cytokine barrier. Let's see one by one. Physical barrier. Physical barrier are the mechanical barrier. That includes skin, mucous membrane, cilia, as well as mechanical action. Let's see one by one. As we know, skin, which covers the body, they are the outermost impermeable barrier which prevent the entry of microorganism. Hence, skin is the first line of defense mechanism against the pathogen. So what is skin? Our body is externally covered with skin, and it acts like an outermost impermeable barrier which prevents the entry of microorganisms. Hence, skin is the first line of defense against the pathogen. Let's see the second barrier, that is mucous membrane. So where we can see mucous membrane? Mucous membrane is present in the respiratory pathway, GI tract, as well as urinogenital tract. So mucous membrane, which is present in respiratory pathway, GI tract, that is gastrointestinal tract, as well as urinogenital tract. When the pathogen enter these tract, the mucus which is present in the tract, they trap and immobilize them or kill them, and that is nothing but mucous membrane. The next one is cilia. Cilia is also present in hairs of the nose, which kill the dust as well as microorganism. So where you can see cilia, it is a network of hairs which are present in the ears as well as nose. The dust or the microorganism, when get enter into the nose or ears, it will trap it and it will kill it, and that is nothing but cilia. The next one is mechanical action. What are the mechanical action you do? Closure of your eyelids, coughing, sneezing, etc. are nothing but mechanical action you do when any pathogen enter the body. So that will make to drive out the microorganisms. So what is mechanical action? So it is a mechanical action which is done by the body unavailingly. They are nothing but closure of your eyelids, coughing, sneezing, etc. So this mechanical action will drive out the microorganisms. So that is nothing but physical barrier. Physical barriers are skin, mucous membrane, cilia, as well as mechanical action. Skin, as we know, it is the outermost covering of the body. It is an impermeable barrier which prevent the entry of microorganism. Hence, it shows first line of defense. So as we know, mucus, which is present in the lining of GI tract, respiratory pathway, urinogenital pathway, it will immobilize the microorganisms. The next one is cilia. Cilia, which is present in hairs and ears, to trap the microorganism. Even you can see the mechanical action are nothing but closure of eyelids, coughing, sneezing, etc. which will drive out the microorganisms which is present in the body. The second one is physiological barrier. Let's see about physiological barrier. Physiological barrier include lysosomes, earwax, even skin, as well as human milk and then vaginal secretion. Let's see one by one. So what are lysosomes? Lysosomes are antibacterial enzymes. So what are lysosomes? Lysosomes are antibacterial enzymes. And these antibacterial enzymes which are present in the tears, nasal secretion, saliva, even you can see in human milk also. And these antibacterial enzymes, when it act on bacteria, they lyse the bacterial cell wall and kill it. And that is nothing but lysosome. So what is lysosome? It act like an antibacterial enzyme. And these lysosomes which are present in tears, nasal secretion, saliva, as well as you can also see in human milk. So how it will kill the bacteria? So these lysosomes, when it is sprayed on the cell wall, they lyse the bacterial cell wall and they kill it. And that is nothing but lysosome. The next one is earwax. So earwax is nothing but brownish waxy secretion which are produced by the seruminous gland of the ear canal. So earwax is nothing but brownish in color which are produced by seruminous gland which are present in the ear. And these earwax which will kill the pathogen which is getting entered into the ears. The next one is even skin is also one of the physiological barrier because skin is a self-disinfectant barrier because it contains two types of gland, sudorific gland and sebaceous gland. So both the glands, sudorific gland will secrete sweat whereas sebaceous gland will secrete oil. So sudorific gland will secrete sweat whereas sebaceous gland will secrete oil. And these secretion has an antiseptic effect to kill the pathogen. So what is skin? Skin is a self-disinfectant barrier which consists of two types of glands, sudorific gland which produces sweat whereas sebaceous gland which produces oil. And these sweat and oil has antiseptic effect to kill the pathogens. So let's see about human milk. Human milk which is rich in an antibacterial substances, they are nothing but lactoferritin as well as neuraminic acid. So human milk which is rich in antibacterial substances like lactoferritin as well as neuraminic acid. Both lactoferritin and neuraminic acid will kill the bacteria. So now let's see about vaginal secretion. As we know, vaginal mucous membrane contain vaginal mucous membrane secrete two types of substances. They are hydrogen peroxide as well as antibiotic to kill the pathogen. As well as it alter the pH of the uterus and make unfit for the growth of pathogen. So what is that? Vaginal secretion which are produced by the mucous membrane of the vagina which secrete hydrogen peroxide as well as antibiotics to kill the pathogen or a bacteria. Or it also alters the pH of the uterus and make it unsuitable for the growth of pathogen, and that is nothing but vaginal secretion. So physiological barrier that include an antibacterial enzyme which is present in tears and nasal secretion, they are nothing but lysosomes. Earwax which are present in the seruminous gland which kill the pathogen which is getting entered into the ear. Skin also contains sudorific as well as sebaceous gland which produces sweat and oil which is having an antiseptic agent to kill the bacteria or in pathogens. Human milk has antibacterial substances like lactoferritin as well as neuraminic acid to kill the bacteria. Even the vaginal secretion which produces hydrogen peroxide as well as antibiotics to kill the bacteria. So that is about physiological barrier. Now let us see about cellular barrier. Cellular barrier. So what is cellular barrier? They form internal defense system of the body which forms second line of defense. So cellular barrier form internal defense system of the body and they form second line of defense. It also include phagocytosis as well as NK cells. It include phagocytosis and NK cells or natural killer cells. As well as you can also see a cytokine barrier that is nothing but interferons. Cellular barrier that include phagocytosis, NK cells and cytokine barrier, that is nothing but interferons. Let's see one by one. The first one is phagocytosis. So what is phagocytosis? It is a process in which the phagocytic leukocyte engulf the pathogen and digest it with the help of lytic enzyme. The cells which are involved in phagocytosis are called phagocytes. It is of two types, you can see. They are nothing but neutrophils and monocysts. One more time. What is phagocytosis? It is a process in which the phagocytic WBC cell, they engulf the pathogen and digest it with the help of lytic enzymes. The cells which are involved in phagocytosis process are called phagocytes, and there are two types of phagocytes, you can see. They are neutrophils as well as monocysts. Let's see the phagocytes. The first one is neutrophil. So what are neutrophil? Neutrophils form PMNL. They are nothing but polymorphonuclear leukocytes. Neutrophil form polymorphonuclear leukocytes. They are phagocytic system. These neutrophils are involved in phagocytosis action, hence they show phagocytic system and which are present in the bloodstream. They are non-dividing cells, living cells with multi-lobed condition, granular cytoplasm, you can see. So one more time, I am telling about phagocytosis. Phagocytosis is a process where the phagocytic leukocyte engulf the pathogen and digest it with the help of lytic enzymes. As we know, the cells which are involved in phagocytosis are called phagocytes. It is of two type, you can see. The first one is neutrophils and the second one is monocyst. So what are neutrophils? They are PMNL. They are nothing but polymorphonuclear leukocytes. They are non-dividing short-lived cells, multi-lobed nucleus, you can see, with granular cytoplasm. These neutrophils, they undergo phagocytosis in action. The second one is, you can see monocyst in the blood, whereas macrophages in the tissue. Monocyst you can see in the blood, whereas macrophages you can see in tissue. They are mononuclear phagocytic system. Monocysts which are short-lived, whereas macrophages which are long-lived. Both are involved in phagocytosis process. So this is nothing but monocyst or macrophages. The next barrier is nothing but natural killer cells. The next cellular barrier is natural killer cells or NK cells. So what are natural killer cells? Natural killer cells are non-phagocytic, large lymphocytic with large granules, you can see. So what are NK cells? NK cells which is not involved in phagocytosis in action. NK cells, they are not involved in phagocytosis in action. Agar pathogen yavriti kill agutte, they are non-phagocytic, but NK cells are large lymphocytes, you can see, large granules, you can see. They just show natural cytotoxicity and are able to kill the tumorous cells. Natural cytotoxicity, cell in a kill maadadakke chemical substance in a produce maadatte, NK cells will produce the chemical substance to kill the pathogen. Hence, they show natural cytotoxicity and even they can kill the tumorous cells. So NK cells has an ability to identify the infected cell by releasing the cytolytic enzyme like cytolysin and perforin. They kill the pathogen. So what are NK cells? They are non-phagocytosis in action. They do not show phagocytosis, but NK cells are the type of WBC with large granules, you can see. They show natural cytotoxicity. That means naturally they produce the chemical substance to kill the pathogen. Hence they show natural cytotoxicity. Even they have an ability to kill the tumors. They have an ability to kill the tumor cells. So NK cells which can identify the virus infected cell by releasing the chemical substance cytolysin as well as perforin, they kill the pathogen. And the last one you can see, it is cytokine barrier. So what is cytokine barrier? They are the special line of defense mechanism. Cytokines, they are nothing but special line of defense mechanism. The cell which is infected with virus produces an antiviral substances called interferons, or you can say it as lymphokinase. So what is cytokine barrier? Cytokine, they form the special line of defense mechanism. When a cell is infected with virus, they produces an antiviral substance called interferons or lymphokinase. These antiviral substances protect the non-infected cells from further viral infection and play a major role in innate immune response. So what is cytokine barrier? They are the special line of defense mechanism. These cells invade by the virus producing, cytokines, they form a special line of defense mechanism. The cell which is infected with virus which are producing an antiviral substance called interferons, or you can say it as lymphokinase. These interferons, which will protect the non-infected cell from further viral infection and play a major role in innate immune response. So this is about the innate immunity. So once again, innate immunity, it is of four types you can see: physical, physiological, cellular as well as cytokine. Physical barrier, that include skin, mucous membrane, cilia as well as mechanical action. Whereas physiological barrier, that include lysosomes, earwax, skin secretion, human milk as well as vaginal secretion. Even you can see the third one is nothing but cellular barrier. Cellular barrier, that include phagocytosis as well as NK cell. Phagocytosis process only involve the cells in cells, two types either, and they are nothing but neutrophils and monocysts. So when you see the NK cells, they are non-phagocytosis in action, but they show natural cytotoxicity by producing cytolysin and perforin. They kill the pathogen. And the last barrier is cytokine barrier. As we know, it shows special line of defense mechanism. The cell which is infected with virus produces an antiviral substance called interferons or lymphokinase. These antiviral substances, which protect the non-infected cell from further viral infection and play a major role in innate immune response. And that is nothing but innate immunity.